Hey everyone, welcome back. As you guys already know, we have some videos already on the channel to explain how to perform the diagnostic on the canvas. And of course, when you are checking the canvas, checking the waveform on the canvas is quite important as well. Of course, there are some inspection that we can do on the canvas with the multimeter. You can find the link for that video on this video's description. But checking the canvas with oscilloscope is always more effective. On those videos, I also explain how to read the waveform and how to analyze the waveform using the oscilloscope. But many of you ask me to explain how to do it with some budget oscilloscopes as well. So that's why today I'm making this video to explain how you can perform the diagnostic on the canvas, how you can read the waveform and analyze the waveform on the canvas to do the diagnostic using this multimeter oscilloscope. So this is the brand of this multimeter oscilloscope that I'm using today. So this one is actually a oscilloscope, multimeter, and pulse generator. I'm not gonna focus on the multimeter function today because of course it's like any other digital multimeter. At the top, as you see, I have two channels because this one is actually a two-channel oscilloscope. This one is for pulse generator. I have already connected one cable on the channel one because I'm gonna check the canvas high and canvas low separately on oscilloscope. If you turn on the device, on the welcome screen, you can select between different functions. I have the oscilloscope here. If you scroll, you can go on the multimeter or on the pulse generator as well. I just leave it on oscilloscope, and here's the oscilloscope page. So on the main page, you can select between channel one and channel two. If you go to the menu, you can turn off the channel one and channel two. So right now, if I scroll down, you see channel one can be turned on and off from here, and channel two as well. I have already turned off the channel two because I'm using only one channel. You can adjust the trigger from here for auto function. You can put it on the auto function or on the falling edge or rising edge based on the signal that you are getting. And if you go up, you can actually select what sort of information you need to be shown on the oscilloscope. I need maximum and minimum voltage right now because it's quite important on the canvas. So I selected these two. Of course, you can go for other options as well. If you go back to the main screen, you have the time frame per division right now. And this is the voltage per division. So it means 1 volt shown in here. It means each division right now here on the screen equals to 1 volt. You can adjust this too. I will show you shortly how to do it. So everything is ready. Let's go for capturing the waveform. As you guys might know, for checking the canvas, the best location is on the OBD2 connector, because on the OBD2 connector, we have two pins, normally pin number 6 and 14, which are actually connected to the canvas network, high speed canvas network. So this pin that I have already inserted, this one is the canvas high, this one is canvas low. So the best access for the canvas is just right here. So I'm gonna insert this one on the canvas high right now. And on my oscilloscope, I put this one here and this one for a ground. And right after doing this, because my oscilloscope is on, I have the waveform, ignition switch must be on. I have the waveform right now on the oscilloscope. This is exactly what I want. So as you see, oscilloscope is capturing the waveform. If I pause it, you can go for auto function as well. If you select the auto, oscilloscope is gonna adjust the setting based on that waveform that you are getting. But I really prefer to do everything manually to make sure that waveform is exactly on that range that I want. Because generally when you are reading the waveform on the canvas high, this voltage should be changing from 2.5 to 3.5. So it means there is 1 volt change over here. For changing the voltage level, because voltage is on this section, right now we have 1 volt per division. So if you click this up and down button, you're gonna change the voltage level. So right now, as you see, this waveform is quite small. I can change the voltage setting to 500 millivolts to have a taller waveform. As you see, the waveform is taller. And if I click this right and left, I'm gonna change the time setting. As you see, the time setting is different, and as you see, waveform is showing up faster. I cannot read anything right now, so I changed the time setting to this, which is quite nice for this waveform. As I explained earlier, the waveform that we are expecting on the canvas high, should be changing between 2.5 and 3.5. So the minimum voltage right here is 2.5, and the maximum voltage is 3.5. So right now, as you see, the voltage minimum is 2.5, but the max voltage is 4. But you got to be careful that this max voltage, which is shown here, is not exactly at this point, because we have some section of the waveform right here, which is giving us a slightly higher voltage. But the voltage that we are expecting, that 3.5, is just right here. So for calculating the voltage, I can click on the select. So this cursor is going to read the voltage for me. So right now, as you see, cursor is on minimum voltage, which is reading exactly what we want, 2.5. And if I go to the maximum voltage, let's see what we're gonna get. So this is the maximum voltage that we are getting. It's 3.6, which is exactly what we want. We want something close to 3.5. And this is exactly what this oscilloscope is showing us. So it's capturing the waveform quite nicely, and we have all the settings to adjust it properly to something that we can read properly. And if I switch it right now from canvas high to canvas low, let's see what's gonna happen. So already waveform changed to canvas low waveform, which in this case is gonna change from 2.5 to 1.5. As you see, the voltage is 2.5. at the base voltage, this is the base voltage. So here's the base voltage, and 1.5 is down here. Again, if I go for selection, so this cursor is gonna read the voltage for me, just right here, 1.4 volt, minimum voltage, which is quite nice. And it confirms that the maximum and minimum voltage on the canvas is okay as well. So basically, when we are checking the canvas with the oscilloscope, we want to make sure if waveform actually exists, because if something happens to the canvas, you may have no waveform right here, which is showing that the network is down. After that, we need to check the maximum and minimum voltage exactly like what we did. We are trying to make sure there is no abnormality on the waveform as well, just to make sure there is no noise affecting the canvas. All right, guys, this was a quick video to show how you can use this budget oscilloscope for checking the canvas. Of course, you can use this one for other components as well. I'm gonna make some other videos as well to explain how you can use this budget oscilloscope for checking other systems and some components on the engine as well. Thank you very much for watching. If you are interested to learn more about this device, you can find the link for this product in the description.